Yes, it is. It is a miracle for us. When I started here in 2000, we didn't realize about the building or anything, but we just need to. We wanted to work for God. You know, after 3 years being here, seeing people coming and leaving because our facility was old and we didn't have the, you know, the classrooms. We didn't have the things that we needed to in order to provide a better service. I saw them, you know, I was sad to see them leaving.
Yeah, our church has always been very much involved with Transformation Ministries, and one day Pastor Rainel called up and asked if he could come meet with me, and so we made an appointment and he came to meet, and he actually tells the story better, but...
And one day, we were driving to my house, and First Baptist is toward the way, you know, it's on the way. And my daughter, Angie, she told me, "Dad, you have to go today." So we went, and I set up a meeting with Pastor Young. And Pastor Young, lads, we find that he's a missionary man.
He came into my office, kind of explained, you know, that their church needed some help and was, you know, needed to try to fix up their building, expand it. And I said, "That's great, but next week I'm going on vacation. My schedule's crazy. So when I get back from vacation, I'll give you a call," which he probably thought I was blowing him off. Actually, I went home that night and I couldn't get out of my mind that this was something that God was saying we needed to do. So.
But he called me next day to meet me the next day.
We got a group and we came over and saw the church and listened to Pastor Aynell's vision for the church and decided that we needed to be a part of what God was doing, and that was over 6 years ago now.
I mean, the thought was that originally was, you know, the ladies were able to sit in the sanctuary, sometimes the men had to stand, and so the original thing was, you know, maybe we'll just blow out a wall and add on to the sanctuary.
Pastor Lutz called me on the phone one day and said, "Oh, we have a little project, could you help us out?" And of course, it was just a tiny little project at that time, and I said, "Oh, sure." And then it grew, and it grew, and it grew, and then pretty soon we just scrapped it all and started all over. And then, of course, as other people became part of the team, then it took roots and become a real church.
With respect to this particular church, you know, as there was a community of pastors who were trying to come alongside the church and help the church do some additions. And in that process, and in the process of participating, I began to question whether we could almost build a new church for a reasonably different but similar cost to doing those additions, and then have a brand new facility for the community and for this church instead of a 1930 building with a scabbed on new construction method.
Mike came to my office and, you know, he was looking for somebody to build his project. You know, he's the donor. It doesn't happen without the money, and it'd either be a bank or, in this case, it's special circumstance. Mike had some money to put forward to something he had a passion for, and his wife is also.
My dad was a mining engineer, very hardworking, a great saver, and lived pretty frugally. He was very, very careful. So what he left me, I felt, was precious to him, and it wasn't, I didn't want to spend it frivolously on myself or something that would fade away. So I said, "Okay, I have this amount of money, I want to invest it in something eternal." Therefore, this was what we were doing, was to say, I can invest this money in a church where people and God's word are eternal.
Michael Van Diel had given me a call and asked me to be involved in selecting finishes, the backgrounds, kind of the overall look for the church.
I feel really touched and thankful. You know, we recently completed another church that was our home church, and I'll never forget the day that, you know, I was walking in the parking lot and I looked at the building and I just thought, thank you, God, for letting me be a part of this, to just join the work. And I have the same feeling about this. And I remember in our own church, standing in the front row and looking back at all of the congregation in one building instead of in three different services. And I just teared up out of thankfulness to be able to join God's work.
You know, my heart is warmed by the people who are willing to step out in faith. And also just the importance of developing relationships in the community. You never know what's going to come out of those. The architect, Charles Brown, who donated his services to the church, was our architect at First Baptist 13 years ago when we went through a remodel process, and it was out of that relationship that when we needed an architect, we showed up in his office and, you know, cast the vision, and he's been an incredible member of the team.
I want to further the kingdom of God, of course. And it's part of my community, this little church, and I want to give back. I don't have a lot of money, but what I do have, which can come out more in architectural and services, I can give.
You know, I'm not a minister. I'm just a lay person, and I have a tool that the Lord gave me to help the church and help it convey its message.
This facility is a miracle from where it started years ago, just praying and thinking of little things that we could possibly do to help the church be able to reach out to more in their community. And now to walk in today, I mean, I've drove by a number of times, but I've never been inside the facility until today. And it's incredible. I mean, you can tell it's a God thing, and it's been done with excellence.
Well, you know, the importance of churches, I mean, they really are the center of community. I believe that churches bring people together for a good cause, a good reason. Obviously, it's just not a meeting place where they meet their friends, but it's also a healing place. It's also a refuge. It's also a place where individuals can provide counseling and soothing the soul, a variety of things that cities can't do.
Well, it's interesting. We start this Sunday with our study in our church of the book of Acts for the next 6 months. And really, that's the mindset of the Church of Acts. They were never focused as the local church. It was always focused on the kingdom. What needs to happen next for the kingdom? I think if we become focused just on our church, that's when we begin to die.
The first thing is, you know, to reach out those souls out there. But at the same time, try to do the same thing that somebody else did with us. Try to help others that they're not capable, you know, that they don't have the same opportunity as we do. And I will tell other pastors, other churches, to partnership, because it is better for the kingdom of God. We can reach out in a better way, and you will have more productivity. You will have more better results if you partnership.
I think the last thing we want to do is die with what God's given us all in our possession. Then we haven't invested it where God would have used it. And you can edit that out. I think it's a real thought. I don't want to die with it all in my possession. What have I done with it? I kept it.
Yeah.
You know, there's a parable that goes with that, I know. Yes. But I don't want to be the one that buried it in the ground.
Yeah.
Well, we never expected to receive this. And I thank God, because whenever somebody says something that I accomplished something, I tell them, no, it is God. It is for, He has done this, not me.